our insane defense budget. This is an opinion piece by Bill Collier, our editor. So I am reading our editor, who happens to also be my identical twin. So he knows I'm doing this. It's cool, folks. It's cool. Our defense budget is insane. We spend too much on defense. There are three reasons for this. One, the defense industry pillages and plunders us with inflated cost and mass inefficiency. Two, the military structure has the logistical tail wagging the warfighting dog. Three, we are empowering our enemies economically, which increases their defense budgets. Yeah. China, looking at you. We need a strong Navy and strategic Air Force. But as for land warfare, a small army backed by a mostly voluntary militia and part-time constabulary and National Guard force. We need real reform on the defense procurement process. We need to have a 4-to-1 ratio of warfighters to support personnel. We can have an overwhelming defense that is proof against any and all enemies and that keeps our sea lanes clear and safe for commerce and to and from our country. So we can continue to be the, which I'm not against that, well, within the nation state parameters, keep the sea lanes open around the world. We need to stop basing troops overseas and defending foreign countries. We need to stop spending too much, paying too high a price, being massively inefficient, and defending foreign countries in ways that do us no good. As for enemies like China, we need total economic separation from them. Our economic entanglement with them renders us vulnerable and grows their power. Well, keep paying attention if you're watching this. Well, keep paying attention to the show because, and if you're watching this clip video form, yeah, keep. Go to the Freedomist YouTube channel, the one with the black and gold, and you'll find a playlist that has all of our shorts on it because we post on different channels, and you'll see what we have coming up. We're going to talk a little bit more about China and the DNC, the love-hate relationship that those two have. So it's a complicated issue. China is an enemy, and we must cut them off, although I totally agree with him. China is an enemy. Oh, let me go back here. As for enemies like China, we need to total economic separation from them. Our economic entanglement with them renders us vulnerable and grows their power. These totalitarian criminals who treat the world as spoil are reprehensible, and we must treat them like dirt because they are execrable lowlifes. Well, and he does mean that the state, the Chairman Xi and his power, not the people themselves. China is an enemy and we must cut them off and possibly block every effort on their part to engage the world economy short of any act of war. There is zero reason to have normalized relations with China. They, the government, not the people, there you go, are evil, period. There's that evil thing again, but... yeah, I'd say China on the scale of evil is pretty high up there. The state, not the people. Empowering our enemies like China and Russia economically is a major reason why our defense budget is growing. We are funding their military expansion and then using that to justify our own excessive military budget, which has these other flaws built into it, such as inflated price from suppliers and massive inefficiencies of organization. People are starving or die without good health care because we let defense industries pillage us through inflated prices, because we have more logistical people than warfighters, and because we economically empower our enemies, all the while expanding our defense mission beyond what is useful in our own country. I completely agree with the editor of The Freedomist, Bill Collier, on that. As his identical twin, I assure you that my views, and also an employee of the Freedomist, I can assure you that, well, amongst other things, but, yeah, I can assure you that, I'm not biased. Not at all. He's right. He's right, you know.